How I would go.
Against myself when demons in my head get loud. I don't know how you do it, but you turn them down. I slip and wonder who I'd be if I never found you and you never found me.
Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Well, I don't wanna see.
Please go get your bride.
So won't you give me tonight? And the rest of your life, I wanna have it all with you. I wanna have it all with you. And when you open your eyes, I'll be there by your side. I wanna have it all with you. I wanna have it all with you.
Before them,
cause your love is biblical.
Lord, because your love has been poured out into their hearts.
If you ever go to teachers, fall between the thunder clouds.
Lord, bless them from this day forward as they today become one flesh. Bless the choices they make, the decisions that have to be made in the future. And help them, Lord, every single day to fall more in love with you than ever before. If that's the case, they will never fail to love one another with an abundant love that you promised. Jesus, Kaylee gets all the attention today, but you're the guest of honor. We invite you, Lord, into our hearts, and I do pray, Lord, that if there's anyone in this group today who doesn't know you, if they're not born again, I pray that what they see here between Grant and Kaylee would change their minds forever about their eternal destination. And they would say, I want what they have. Have your way in this place. We ask for your glory. In Jesus' name, amen. Please be seated. I guess I missed my cue to dance in. Didn't know that was going to happen. You know, a lot of times we like to say things like, this is a match made in heaven, especially at a time like this, a wedding, young people that we've watched grow up here at Calvary Chapel. But this wasn't a match made in heaven. This was a match made at Alto Frio and Baptist Encampment. And it happened because two dads got together and decided that his son, her daughter, and their daughter would probably be good together. Why don't we exchange some numbers? Probably the easiest first date you ever had. And see, I always say I'm all in favor of arranged marriages. So, dads, you did a great job. Keep it up. Now, maybe the two of you should have more kids so you can do it again. Obviously, we're here to celebrate Grant and Kaylee's wedding. But what they represent, do you need Kleenex already? Okay. We need Kleenex out of the bullpen. Thank you. What they represent as they stand before you is far greater than just a husband and a wife who are getting married today. They represent Jesus. I told Grant when the doors open and Kaylee walks in to get on this step beside me so that there was nothing in the way, because what we wanted to see happen was we wanted to see his reaction when she walked in. Before the wedding, I get to go in and pray with her, and she took my breath away. Imagine what she did for you, Grant. And when she walked in, I leaned over and said to you, this is how much God loves you. And this is an opportunity for you to show her how much he loves her. You know, from the very beginning, God said, it's not good that man is alone, and man is a general man there, mankind, men and women. It's not good to be alone. And you guys know that. You've been alone for a while, and now you're starting off on this path. But the best thing about not being alone is when they were together for the first time, they were covered in the glory of God. They walked in the garden, in the cool of the garden, day after day with the Lord. I wish we knew how many days, but we don't. But they walked in the garden with Jesus, and they could do that because they were covered by the glory of God. Your job, Grant, is to make sure that Kaylee is covered in the glory of God, to love her the way Christ loved the church, to love her sacrificially, to love her selflessly, to make sure she knows from this day forward what it really and truly means to be loved. And you're the man, the only man in this planet that God has chosen for that assignment. Kaylee, your job is to love him, to respect him, to follow his leadership. I know you've got 3 years of the United States Army's leadership to deal with as well, but this is really when we begin listening for the voice of God. And you won't be able to hear the voice of God independently. Peter says that husbands and wives are joint heirs of the grace of God together, the grace of life together. That means there's no individual grace. You lose yourself. You become one flesh. There's no more Grant. There's no more Kaylee. There's Grant and Kaylee. And that's the way we should all think when we see you from this moment forward. Hey, they belong together. They belong together. And because I've known both of you for so long, and I'm not going to embarrass you here, but one of the things that I know is that you both hit the jackpot. Kaylee, this is one of the nicest young men I've ever met. He appears quiet and shy, but he's really a nut. He comes by it naturally. I know mom and dad. But he's a gentleman. In the old-fashioned sense, he's kind, and he's patient, and he's loving, and you're about to be loved like you've never been loved before. Grant, I told you when we were doing our crash course premarriage counseling that you've been chosen by God to represent him to Kaylee, to show her once and for all just how much he loves her. And that's in good times and in bad times, loving her the way Christ loved the church, meaning putting her needs ahead of yours, giving yourself up for her. And believe me, she's worth it. I've watched her grow, not just grow up, but grow into a godly woman. And your zeal for the Lord, especially in these last couple of years, has been wonderful to watch. And together, I can't wait to see what God's going to do in terms of ministry and direction for you. The minute you're out of the army, you got to come right back so we can all watch it together. Amen. Having said all that, nobody wants to change their mind? Let's go for this. Let me get your rings out. Grant, you take this ring. Kaylee, you take that ring. Kaylee, I'll speak with you first. Kaylee, do you take Grant to be your husband in the presence of God and these witnesses?
Do.
Repeat after me. I,
Kaylee.
Promise Jesus.
That I will love Grant
before all others.
I will please Jesus.
By submitting to his spiritual leadership.
I will pray for him.
And cherish him.
For the gift from God that he is.
I pledge absolute fidelity.
I will love him in times of wealth and poverty.
And since you're in the army, I should say that again. I will love him in times of wealth and poverty.
In sickness and health.
In good times and bad.
Until Jesus comes for us.
Would you place the ring on his finger? Grant, do you take Kaylee to be your wife in the presence of God and these witnesses?
I do.
Repeat after me.
I, Grant.
Promise Jesus. That I will love Kaylee. The way Jesus loves his church. I will put her desires ahead of my own.
I will pray for her.
And cherish her. For the gift from God that she is.
I pledge absolute fidelity.
I will love her in times of wealth and poverty.
In times of sickness and health.
In good times and bad.
Until Jesus comes for us.
Please place the ring on her finger. Now both of you repeat. Jesus, to please you.
We promise that our marriage
and our lives will be governed by the Holy Spirit.
We realize that from this point forward,
we are no longer two, but one.
It's our desire to please you above all else.
Now, this is where I would normally pronounce you husband and wife, but let me just address our guests here for a moment today. I think the greatest gift that you could give Grant or Kaylee on this day, if you're here and you're not a born-again Christian, is to surrender your heart to Jesus Christ. This is the plan that God had for them. You know, it's hard sometimes to really trust God's plan, especially if you don't know him. You've got a general knowledge about God. We all, I think, have an instinctive knowledge about God. But until you really know him and are loved by him, well, that's when you're missing out. And this is the kind of plan God has for you. Grant, Kaylee, neither one of them would ever have dreamed just a little while ago that this is where they would be today. But this is tangible proof of how good God is. This is the plan that he has for your lives. And all you have to do to become a born-again Christian is to repent of your sins, ask God to forgive you, and then say, Jesus, I haven't done very well on my own, so how about you take over my life? And while you may not be standing in front of a pastor getting married, that's when God's plan for you begins to be worked out, right here in time and space. And I want you just to pay special attention. We're going to go off mic for a moment and take communion, first communion as husband and wife. But please pay special attention to the looks on their faces. This is what God will do if we give him the opportunity. Having said that, now you don't get to kiss yet, so don't get carried away. Now I pronounce you husband and wife. Let's go to the table of communion.
All my words fall short. I got nothing new. How could I express all my gratitude? I could sing these songs as I often do, but every song must end, and you never do. So I throw up my hands and praise you again and again, 'cause all that I have is a hallelujah, hallelujah. And I know it's not much, but I've nothing else fit for a king, except for hearts and
privileged to be here today to participate. This is family, friends, and together we get to watch these two begin their new life together. Pray for them, always be there for them, and love them. Just like they've promised to love each other in good times and bad, love them and let them know that they're always in your prayers. Kaylee Grant, husband and wife, you may now kiss your bride. For the very first time, I introduce you to Mr. and Mrs. Grant Tillery.
Every day in a hundred different ways, I make the choice to stay. I can hit the open road and run my life away, and I choose you every day. I see lovers all around me giving up and giving in. They decided that it's over before it begins. Every day in a hundred different ways, I make the choice to stay. I can hit the open road, run my life away, but I choose you.
Okay, that concludes the ceremony. There is snacks and beverages out in the foyer and your make way out there while they take pictures, and we will get back in here for Din Din.